great that you are interested in automated follow-up processes in steel design. Today's video is about bills of material, shop drawings, sheet metal export to DXF and DSTV NC or NC1 export for manufacturing. We are using this staircase as an example assembly, and if you are interested in how easily and quickly this assembly was created using SolidSteel parametric for SolidWorks, you will find a link to the video in the description. The first step for all subsequent processes is to automatically assign position numbers. To do this, we switch to the SolidSteel parametric tasks on the right. There are several tabs such as to-do list, position numbers, diagnostics, and project management. We are already in the right tab and can start assigning position numbers by simply clicking update. Identical parts are now recognized based on the geometry of all the parts. This gives identical parts identical position numbers with an indication of the number of parts required. The position number assignment is complete, and we get a list sorted by assemblies and components. There is also a facades category. This is due to the way we installed the gratings on the platform in the construction video, so don't get confused. The gratings are also listed according to the lengths used, which are the three shorter ones and the two longer ones. Now that we have the position numbers, we need to write all the information to the custom properties of each component using the update metadata function from the BOM menu at the top. This will allow us to use this information later in the exports. I use the standard data predefined in SolidSteel parametric, such as position number, length, hierarchy number, material, etc., which is completely sufficient in most cases. However, you can also define custom categories, which gives you complete freedom. By the way, the metadata update is complete when the currently grayed out icons in the menu bar return to color. Okay, the process is finished and all preparations for the following processes are done. I'll collapse all open folders in the structure tree on the left with Shift plus C, which is completely optional, but looks nicer. Let's start with the bill of materials. In the dialog on the left, we define the details. In the first drop-down menu, we select the basic type of our list. There are different templates for metric and imperial lists. I choose the BOM list, which contains all the information of the individually selectable lists such as beam list, sheet list, etc., with metric dimensions. In the second selection, we can choose the Excel template. SolidSteel Parametric provides two templates that you can customize with your company logo and other details. I choose the English template. The third option allows us to specify what we want to export. Here we can select the main assembly or existing sub-assemblies. Sub-assemblies would be, for example, the individual railings, but I will stick with the entire assembly. Now we just need to define the file path for the export. I just select my desktop and name the export BOM. Clicking on the green checkmark starts the export process. Again, the export is complete when the gray icons in the menu bar return to color, but it only takes a few seconds, it's already done. Let's take a look at the result. The bill of materials is clearly structured, and you can access the various lists from the individual sheets within the Excel file. The bolt list shows us all the bolted joints with the type and number of bolts, washers, and nuts. The saw list shows all profiles to be cut, their number, profile type, length, cuts with angles, individual weight, and total weight. The structure list has a hierarchical structure and shows us assemblies and sub-assemblies. Here, for example, subassembly 1-2, with the listed U profiles, which should be one of the stair stringers. And if we scroll down, we can see all the other subassemblies with the required parts. The beam list lists the materials sorted by profile type and size, and the sheet list lists all the sheets sorted by sheet thickness and material. The quantity list shows us the entire assembly sorted by position number. As you can see, everything has been thought of, and the best part is that even after making changes to the design, you will have the BOM with the steps shown up to date and error-free in no time at all. So much for the bills of materials, now let's move on to exporting the shop drawings. We can find the right tool for this here at the top under Drawings. Before exporting the drawing, you will be asked if you want to update the position numbers. However, if you have not opened the file in a while, or if you are not sure whether a colleague has made changes that you are not aware of, please reassign the position numbers. The 1 to 2 minutes is really time well spent. I'm going to click no because we just did the update, and I can be 100% sure that nothing has changed since then. The drawing assistant opens with the drawing summary. Everything you can create a drawing for is listed here. So the main assembly, sub-assemblies, welded assemblies, profiles, sheets, etc. There are no drawings of this assembly yet, which is why Create is shown everywhere under Action. Here on the top right we can set the sheet format globally for the drawings. I choose DIN A2 here. The plates also fit on smaller sheet sizes, so I set them individually to A4 portrait. The file path for the export fits, but you could of course also change it here. An order number is still missing. I name the order staircase underscore drawings. In the drawing name column, we can now see how the names change. I have set it so that the name is a combination of the order number plus the position number. However, you can personalize this to your liking and of course you can also make changes manually. Now we just click export and see how SolidSteel Parametric displays all the parts for the drawings before the drawing export begins. The actual export of the workshop drawing starts with the main assembly. It looks a bit chaotic, but you can later, for example, hide all the origins of the coordinate system shown here in blue. While the computer is working for us, we are always shown the drawings for a short time and can see, for example, how the dimensional chains are created. By the way, for the dimensional chains, you can specify in the settings whether the dimensioning should be done as a chain or as an ordinate dimensioning. This takes a few minutes. For example, here on my computer it was 5 minutes and 40 seconds in real time, which I sped up for the video. The speed depends on the computer, and my machine isn't a rocket. But no matter how slow the computer is, compared to doing the drawings by hand, this is done in the blink of an eye. At the end of the export, a message appears that everything has been exported successfully, and a note that the assembly should now be saved in order to retain the metadata for existing drawings. This way, the next time you use the drawing assistant, it will know which drawings already exist and where they were saved. Now let's take a look at the export. In the selected folder, a subfolder named with the order number was created and further folders were created in which the drawings were saved sorted by assembly, beam, plate and WCA, which is the welded assemblies. Let's have a look at a beam, for example the position number 1030 here. Here we have a U profile with some holes. The dimensions, here as ordinate dimensions, and also the break lines have been added automatically. All dimensions are well positioned here, the drawing could be used as it is. However, sometimes you need to make some manual adjustments using the normal SOLIDWORKS functions. We can now add an isometric view of the component, for example, but this is also a standard SOLIDWORKS feature that you are probably familiar with. I mentioned earlier that you can hide the origins shown in blue. You can do that from the view menu here at the top, and then just click here. Here is a drawing of a stair stringer with many holes and miter cuts. As I said, all dimensions can be edited, so let's move the hole diameter as an example and add the number of holes to the text. That's it! There is also a separate video about making shop drawings, which is also linked in the description. Alright, let's move on to the next subsequent process, which is exporting the sheet metal to DXF. Normally, a position number update and a metadata update should also be carried out before this export. We already did this at the beginning of the video, I just wanted to mention it. We find the right feature for the DXF export here at the top in the drawings menu. The dialog opens again on the left, and we see that we can select components in the first tab to export individual sheets. In the second tab, we have the option to select by assemblies or sub-assemblies. Here I select the current assembly, in other words the assembly that is currently visible, so that all existing sheets are selected for export. An order number is assigned again, and just below that you can choose to have the quantity included in the file name. The normal SOLIDWORKS options are available in the export options. The suggested file path is okay for me. I confirm to start the export. When exporting, SolidSteel opens each sheet to be exported and then saves it as a DXF. This is done quickly. Let's take a look at the export folder. Again, there is a subfolder named with the order number, another folder named with a timestamp, and within that there are folders named with the sheet thickness. For example, in the folder named 25mm we find the DXF file of the end plate, and at the end of the file name after the order number we find the position number 2000 and the quantity 2. In the 10mm folder we find the small sheet of the railing with the position number 2001 and the quantity 23. We can imagine what the DXF files look like. I won't even open them now. They are simply rectangles with two holes, just like the short 3D preview during the export, only in 2D. Now we come to the topic of DSTV NC or NC1 exports. Since NC data is not only important for designers, but especially for manufacturers or steel traders, we have developed the DSTV Assistant for SolidWorks as a standalone add-in. I enabled the DSTV Assistant in the settings under add-ins. The DSTV Assistant naturally works perfectly with SolidSteel parametric, but can also process any other 3D format that can be opened with SolidWorks, regardless of the CAD system used to create the data. Okay, we switch to the DSTV Assistant and see the new menu bar at the top. Clicking on the first menu item Quick Start for Assembly starts the analysis of the assembly. A geometric equal parts detection is performed and we soon get the result. There it is. The list starts here at the top with the assembly, and when we open it we see the identified profiles and the plates. In the plates we have all the end plates. Then we have the U profiles of the stringers and the horizontal beam, the I profiles of the columns, the flat bars, the round bars with which the handrail and the segments were connected to the posts, and at the very end, the L profiles. The L profiles are somewhat hidden in the clip angle connections. If you are looking for a component, you can also simply right-click on the entry and select Zoom to selection from the context menu. The component is still hidden in this view, but you can see it clearly from the other side. Okay, since there were no unrecognized parts here, we can simply right-click on the assembly and select Export All to start exporting the NC data. Here on the left in the export dialog we see an overview of the profiles to be exported at the top, and directly below we can assign an order number. Under File Extension, we select whether we want to export with the .nc or .nc1 file extension. Under Export Blocks, we can activate or deactivate the machining operations, such as drilling, signatures, etc., and thus the NC blocks that we want to export. At the bottom we can specify the desired file path again, and the preparations are complete, so we can confirm to start the export. This only takes a moment, and the export is complete when the menu icons return to color. Okay, let's have a look at the result. In the specified export folder we find a subfolder named after the order number, which in turn contains a folder with a timestamp, and in this folder we find all the NC files. Let's open one of the U profiles with an NC viewer. There is the component, and as we can see from the length, the miter cut, and the two holes, this is one of the profiles on the stair platform. So it is virtually the place where we just looked at the L profile of the clip angle connection. As a second example, here is the NC file of the stair stringer that we just saw as a shop drawing, opened in an editor. We see various general information at the top, such as order number, position number, material, profile name and profile type, followed by the machining blocks, such as outer contour and holes. And yes, we also have a detailed video on DSTV NC and NC1 in steel design showing how to edit profiles imported from other CAD systems or how to easily include unrecognized profiles. Just click on the suggested video here. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.